There are two different ways that humans become the way we are: influence from our environment and influence from our genetics. Genetics have a much bigger influence on who we are than most people think. There are the obvious things that genetics influence, like intelligence, athletic ability, and the size of your junk, yet there are many traits that are much less obvious. Number 10. Laziness. Some people are just extremely lazy. They'd rather binge-watch Netflix than get some work done. It's extremely common for people to question why they have this innate sense of laziness that they just can't seem to shake. Well, lazy people, rejoice. It's not all your fault. You can blame it on your genetics. Researchers discovered laziness genes when they bred two groups of rats. They bred the most active rats and then the least active rats. As the generation of rats continued, the rats with the active parents ran longer and longer, while the rats with the less active parents didn't run nearly as much. The researchers accounted for many factors, including physical characteristics, muscle cells, levels of mitochondria, etc., but they found the biggest reason for their activity and inactivity was a set of around 36 genes that accounted for their motivation to exercise. So basically, everyone who has said there's no excuse for being lazy, well, they've all been wrong. Number 9. How well you deal with stress. Stress has an effect on everyone at one point or another. Whether someone is going through a divorce, a long work week, or gender reassignment surgery, we all have stressful times. The way that stress affects people is largely influenced by their genetics. Stress effects can be seen in the hippocampus region of the brain. When someone goes through a stressful event, their hippocampus either increases or decreases. The size change happens depending on the number of risk genes that someone harbors. The more risk genes, the more the hippocampus will decrease in volume, which will make that person have a negative reaction to that stressful event. If there are very little risk genes, then the stressful event could have a reverse effect and actually be very positive to the person. This predisposition to the effects of stress has a major overall effect on someone's ability to handle critical life moments that may induce stress, which makes the odds stacked against some people who have many risk genes. Number 8. Your willingness to travel. There are many people who enjoy travel, and there are just as many people who despise it. People who enjoy it have a gene called DRD47R, or the Wanderlust gene. People who have this gene have higher levels of restlessness and curiosity. They enjoy exploring new places and don't like being stationary. The gene has been traced back to people with ancestors that have a history of traveling. Human life is said to have started in Africa, thus populations who have traveled far from Africa have a higher chance of possessing the gene. Not only do people with the gene enjoy traveling more, but they're also more willing to take risks and explore new relationships, foods, and even drugs. They welcome change and adventure. Lastly, the gene is not particularly common, as it's only found in around 20% of the population. Yet, if you do the maths of about 7 billion people, that would mean about 1.4 billion people in the world possess the gene. Number 7. Driving skills. Driving seems like a simple enough task. Don't run into people or other cars and you're golden. Then why are there so many accidents? Well, if you've been watching the video up to this point, you would know that it's definitely because of genetics. Researchers have found a certain gene variant that makes people worse at driving. People with the variant perform more than 30% worse on driving tests, and 30% of Americans possess the genes. So 3 out of every 10 people on the road could potentially kill you due to their lack of driving skills. The reason people with the gene are much worse at driving is because of an improper amount of BDNF, which is a protein in the brain. BDNF assists in retaining memory and is essential for the communication between brain cells. Thus, it's much harder to get better at driving because it's harder to retrain driving skills through practice. Number 6. Susceptibility to addiction. Addiction is one of the absolute worst things that a human being can go through. Scientists have found a genetic influence when it comes to becoming addicted. Genes account for over 50% of a person's susceptibility to drug addiction, and with drug use in America at an all-time high, addiction has become a huge problem. Physicians would be able to treat addiction better if they understood genetic tests better, as only 5% of physicians have confidence in their ability to understand the tests. So basically, good treatment is quite hard to find. Furthermore, genetics have an influence on why someone will start using drugs. For example, with tobacco, 75% of a person's tendency to start smoking is based on their genetics, while 60% of their likelihood to become addicted and 54% of their capability to quit is also based on genetics. Thus, genetics account for a large percent than environmental factors in the different characteristics of addiction. Number 5. Violence. Extremely violent people are the scourge of society. There's no place for them, so we often throw them in prison. As much as we want it to be completely their fault because of how relentless and annoying violent people can be, genetics is a very big factor to blame as well. Researchers in Finland took a genetic analysis of 900 criminals and have found that two genes are associated with making people violent. People with the genes were 13 times more likely to have a background of violence. Still, Jari Tahonen, who headed up the study, said it's highly unlikely that people with these genes will start going off on killing sprees. Even if someone possesses most of the genes, they'll more than likely never commit a violent crime, but are just more likely to do so compared to the general population. Even an Italian court reduced a murderer's sentence because it was discovered that the murderer had the genes that were linked with violent behavior. Number 4. Exactly what you should eat. Forget everything you know about diets and dieting, because it's all a lie. Well, it's not entirely a lie, but there is a better way to lose weight and become healthier. Listen to the advice from your own personal genetics. University of Toronto researchers found that personalized nutrition based on individual genetic makeup improves eating habits. When the researchers gave their test subjects advice based on their genetics, their diets had improved compared to the subjects who were given standard dietary advice. For example, the researchers found a gene linked to high blood pressure and salt intake in some subjects who were then given advice about it. They saw a much better improvement on their sodium intake compared to subjects who were given standard advice on salt intake. Number 3. Musical taste. In a study of almost 4,000 twins, it was found that musical taste is partially based on our genetics. For people under 50, genetic influence of music taste is about 55%. Thus, genes have a much bigger influence on music taste compared to environmental factors before the age of 50. As people grow older, though, environment has more of an influence. For people over 50, genetics only has about a 40% influence, while environment accounts for the other 60%. Genes still have a big influence, but with time that influence depletes. The study also accounted for each individual genre of music and how much genes have an influence on liking a particular genre. For people under 50, genes had a 56% influence on jazz, blues, and soul music, a 53% influence on pop, classical, rap, and hip-hop music, a 53% influence on rock, indie, heavy metal music, and genes had no influence on country folk before the age of 50, but it had a 28% influence after people were above the age of 50. Furthermore, our motivation to listen to music is less based on our genes, with genes having a 25% influence. Number 2. Mate selection. There's more to human attraction than meets the eye. When choosing a mate, it's not just attractiveness or intelligence that influences the choice. It goes deeper than that. Specifically, something called major histocompatibility complex, or MHC. Our major histocompatibility complex comes from our genetics and has a subtle impact on who we are attracted to. In short, we're attracted to people with a different MHC than us. In a study of 90 married couples and 152 other random couples, it was found that the couples had very different MHCs. If MHC genes had no influence, they wouldn't have found such differing MHCs in the study. The reason we're attracted to people with differing genes can be found in our evolution. Diversity between mates yields healthier children. Thus, we evolved to go after partners that are different from us. Also, the MHC helps stop inbreeding because we're less attracted to people who we have similar genes to. So, genetics is the ultimate reason incest isn't common, unless you live in Westeros, that is. That and the fact that, well, it's just plain icky. Number 1. Phobias. It's thought that phobias are developed through particularly bad life experiences that may cause irrational fears, but according to a study conducted at Emory University School of Medicine in Atlanta, phobias can be passed down through generations. Different experiences can be inherited from your ancestors, which also causes you to take on their phobias. This was found by taking mice and making them fear cherry blossoms by using electric shocks when they smelled them. After they completely feared the smell of cherry blossoms, the researchers made them breed. Their offspring had an innate fear of the smell of cherry blossoms, even though they hadn't been exposed to it before. It's beneficial that a phobia is passed down from your ancestors, because then you know what's bad and what isn't. In the modern world, many of the fears you inherited may be obsolete, but could have been important years ago. For example, maybe your ancestor had a bad experience with spiders, and that's the reason you're arachnophobic. Or if your ancestors lived in the African savanna, you could have naturally developed a fear of lions, even though you've never encountered one before. And if you're not afraid of lions for whatever reason, rest assured your stupidity is definitely genetic. So I really hope you found that video interesting. If you did, please do smash that like button below, and don't forget to subscribe. Also, when you're subscribing, make sure you hit that bell so you know when we put out a new video. Also, why not check out my other channel? It's called Geographics. Please find that linked to below. It's a geography channel. Maybe you'll like it as well. And thank you for watching.